Now let's create a 3-column grid that can hold separate text frames. Again, I will build it in both InDesign and Scribus. In InDesign, I go to File, New, Document. I set the document to a single page. In InDesign, the page size is A4, and the margins are set at 12.7 millimeters. When the margins chain is closed, when you change a value, the value for all four margins stay the same. In Scribus, I will close the chain, and set the margins the same as in InDesign, at 12.7 millimeters. I want the bottom however to be a bit higher, so I unlock the chain. I set the bottom margin to 20 millimeters, and click on OK. I do the same in InDesign. In the last lecture, we created in both InDesign and Scribus a text frame with 3 columns. For more flexibility however, I want 3 individual text frames. In InDesign, I can create a grid for this. I go to Layout, Margins and Columns. I set columns to 3, and the space between the columns to 5 millimeters. I click on OK. We don't have text frames yet, but the grid is ready. In Scribus I want the same grid. I go to Page, Manage Guides. I click on the Column tab. I set the number to 2. I want the guides to be set relative to the margins. I set the space between the columns to 5 millimeters. I close the window. Functionally, I now have the same in Scribus. But in Scribus I have guides, and in InDesign we have purple margin lines, which I prefer to look of. So in the next 2 lectures, we'll look at how to get this same InDesign grid look in Scribus.